Hello, today I'm going to show you how I overdraw my lips. I think it's around the 40s and 50s that it actually originated from, even though it could have been done before that. And what I'm really going to talk about today is show you how I do it on what it would look like on my natural lips and then what it actually looks like when you overdraw. What lipstick I tend to use and what's my favourite, how I apply the lipstick and the shape that I do. So enjoy. So first of all, I should probably talk about my favourite lipstick. And even though I have seen people that have talked about MAC, that have talked about like Rimmel, L'Oreal and things like that, I tend to go for cheap lipsticks. Cheap everything, cheap and cheerful. So when I try something, like when I actually went into trying red lipstick, I try and get something cheap so I can test it and see if I actually like it on myself before I go and buy more expensive lipstick. And the thing that I've actually found is that one of the cheaper ones that I own is the best for me. I love the colour, I love the feel of it. It lasts a long time, it has like staying power. And I tend to lick my lips quite a lot and, you know, if I'm drinking or if I'm eating, it tends to stay. But it won't obviously be exactly perfect, but it does stay a lot longer than some of the other lipsticks I own. My camera won't cooperate with me, so I won't be able to show you up close to shit, but it's the NYC Expert Last lip colour, and it does. And the shade is Red Rapture, which is awesome. So that is what I'll be applying today, even though it won't be this perfect one that I've not touched to show you. It'll be one that I've used a lot of. This is the one I'm gonna use. It's nearly finished. So I'm lucky I have the other one on hand to show you and to take pretty videos of and pictures of later. So it actually looks more glamorous than this little guy here. Okay, I'm gonna get a bit closer. This is gonna look a bit weird, but okay. So once again, I'm gonna have to trust my handy little hammer to actually see my face. Otherwise, it's gonna be a bit awkward to try and do it. Well, I'm gonna show you the benefits of actually using a brush. I've seen a lot of people just applying the lipstick over their lips without actually kind of tidying it off. And even though there's nothing wrong with it, you hopefully find that it gives a bit of a more polished and kind of cleaner look. So following my natural lip. So that's what it looks like. Not too bad. Of course, when I'm trying to persuade others to use a brush, that lipstick went on perfectly when it usually doesn't. It doesn't usually go on so neat, so that is just typical. Okay, so what I'm gonna do now is try and show you. I'm gonna zoom in again, this is good. Okay. Try and show you the shape. And as I said, I think it's more of a 1940s shape, but I could be wrong, it could be 50s. So it's probably gonna be hard for me to talk through this, but I tend to start here and then I'll take it up around and then to the cupid's bow. So I'll do just another little before. And you can see the difference. Now this does take a little bit of getting used to actually feel like the shape, and there's loads of times where I've done, say, this side thicker than this side, and then you end up a bit uneven. So of course, if you just kind of keep going just a bit at a time and just trying to even them out. So that is that side. I'm gonna get a little bit more lipstick on my brush. Hopefully you can see what I'm doing, because when I'm looking at myself I can't see what's happening in the screen. On this side you usually start at the cupid's bow and then go down. Thank you.
And there we go.
And do along the bottom as well. This one can be quite scary at first. I start from in here, and it's really more about these bits here that I tend to try and round out. That's it. It's gonna feel really weird at first, especially drawing underneath the bottom of your lip. That's a really weird feeling, but you'll get used to it and you'll be able to actually feel when you're going too far, or you know, when you've kind of hit the target as such. There's times where I've really overdrawn and thought that's borderline bad drag queen. You know, if it's good drag queen, perfect. That's exactly what you're looking for, but it's bad drag queen. That's rubbish. And then other times when I've not quite gone so far. So thank you for watching. I hope that's helpful. It's a really short little video just to kind of show you how I do it. If you have any questions, of course, like always, just ask. If you feel like I've kind of rushed through this, I'll of course do it again and add any more information that you want to know. And it's just kind of getting over that kind of scared boundary. That of course, from this distance, it looks fine. But because you're seeing yourself so up close, you can see that it's overdrawn. I hope that's okay. Make sure to always wipe the lipstick off your teeth, you know, if you did a little thumb trick or a bit of tissue, and you can get a bit of lipstick off there. And always, yeah, because nothing worse than that. I would say that I don't need to reapply this lipstick all that much. It probably lasts me about a good 4 hours, but obviously depends on if you're eating a big burger or if you're having like lots and lots of drinks, then obviously it's gonna be a little bit shorter than that. Hopefully you like it and you can do it yourself. I don't really know what we could do with this one. If we could do Katrina lips, doesn't really work as a hashtag, does it? But I'd love to see if you do attempt the overdrawing. Please let me know, because I know quite a lot of people are frightened of it, but need to be, just experiment and have fun. Thank you for watching.